I stomped down the gangplank of the hullbreaker and stepped onto the dock. I couldn't help but wonder why the Admiralty called me into Erdrith so early in the damned North Sea campaign. After all, we'd already sunk four of Milnest's barks and captured a pair of merchantmen. We even handed the crews over to the regular navy for ransom and given them most of the loot we'd taken. Pretty damn honest for a privateer I was. Still, orders were orders after all. My passage turned heads as I made my way to land along the slightly tilted wooden dock. The air was filled with a thick, briny smell that reeked of dead fish and the unmistakable stench of humans. Of course, that's what most of the Empire was made up of, humans. Damn things bred almost as fast as us orcs and lived longer to boot. Bloody unfair if you ask me. More stares and muttering followed me as I headed up towards Lord Broward's keep. I knew these lubbards recognised me. There was no mistaking the only orcish captain in the Imperial Navy. Of course, my rank wasn't really official, but to hell's with anyone that argued it. I'd had their bashed-in heads to the collection strung along the hullbreaker's rails. Unless they were really special, of course. Then their skulls would decorate trapdoors for the ship's 26 below-deck cannons. Or perhaps even one of the six smaller guns on the quarterdeck and forecastle that I'd had installed so she could fire fore and aft as well as on the broadside. "Thank you for coming, Captain Bardeck Skullsplitter," one of the guards said as he gave me a once-over. The look on his face was one I'd come to expect from the Imperials, a thin veneer of pleasantry over a mixture of fear and disgust. "You're welcome," I replied, as I mounted the stairs to the drawbridge of the keep. "I trust there won't be any problems." The pair of guards nodded in response, which was fortunate for them. After all, the last thing I wanted to do was deal with some dumbass who thought he might test my orcish might. It never ended well for them, especially because walking through these damned human towns always put me in a sour mood. It wasn't the glares and the smell of fear, though. It was the looks of disdain, as if I was just a piece of shit on their boots to be cleaned off. Despite everything that orcs had given to build up the Empire during Asmund Blackburn's wars of conquest. At best, we barely rated second-class citizens, assuming, of course, we weren't thrown right into slavery. My scowl deepened as I noted a gang of orcish thralls building a scaffold beneath a guard tower, under the watchful eyes of a pair of human taskmasters. Like me, the thralls were dark-eyed and green-skinned. They were about the same size as their foreman, but close to twice as broad and much more heavily muscled. All of them were a bit shorter than I was, but then I wasn't a slave. I took a deep breath to hold in my anger, and focused on finishing my march to the raised portcullis. Here I was challenged.
"State your business."
The guardsman, a human in an ornate helmet and breastplate, addressed me. "Captain Bardeck Skullsplitter, of the privateer Hullbreaker," I said in a deep, no-nonsense voice. The guard's eyes widened. He probably wasn't used to dealing with eloquent orcs. I smiled around my tusks and continued. "The Admiralty sent me word that I was to report to Lord Broward's keep as soon as possible." The two guards exchanged glances.
"I'll go fetch the sergeant,"
the one who hadn't spoken yet offered.
"No need,"
a man in the uniform of a house servant joined us.
"If the captain will come with me..."
I took an instant dislike to the man. "And who might you be?" I wanted to know.
"I am Vale,"
he replied, as he met my examination of him with a dead-eyed gaze. Damn me, but I'd seen more life in the eyes of a shark.
"Now, if there are no other questions, please follow me."
He turned and walked off at speed, and I followed, keeping pace with him easily. I hadn't missed the pause as Vale said my rank. And not for the last time, I wished I could have brought my axe and pistols to these meetings. They hadn't searched me, perhaps trusting my reputation for following orders. Of course, I was armed, but the blades tucked into my boots would hardly be enough to tickle some of the larger guardsmen I'd seen. Vale led me into the keep proper through a side door, after we crossed the yard. We followed a short passage, then descended a flight of stairs and through another door. Dungeon, of course. It wasn't like you could have a meeting with an orc in broad daylight in a cafe. Not for someone like this. The dim light of the underground halls didn't hold any secrets for me. Broward had a few captives, and most of them barely noticed our passage. But one, a young woman in a barred cell all her own, caught my eye. She was gagged, and her hands were in witch bindings. That explained the solo cell.